Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Gabriel. Today we're talking about the heat issues of helium mining. Some of us live in different parts of the country or different parts of the world, so we all have different temperature problems. Now, if you're dealing with the cold, there are still some things that will apply to you in this video, and I will briefly go over those. But for the most part, we're going to talk about heat and how to get rid of that with options that we have without breaking our bank account. Now, you guys have consistently requested ideas on how to get rid of the heat. Thank you guys for actually bringing this urgency to my awareness. Now, I can't say how much I appreciate you guys. You guys are thinking ahead, thinking about longevity for the project, and this is what this channel is all about. Now, without further ado, guys, today's video is going to consist of three basic things. First, it's going to be my basic ideas for fighting the heat. Second, it's going to be the possible methods we can use for each different kind of install. And then lastly, some potential future planning that we can all get involved in. And I'll be going over that stuff at the end of the video. Now, before we get into that, let's ask a simple question. How serious is this heat problem? What happens if you leave your miner there just over and over again in the sun? Now, the miners do come with a set specification on what temperatures it is best to run in. They do give a minimum and a maximum. Now, what are some things that we could be seeing if we're kind of just tiptoeing on the edge of this temperature or maybe going above that? So bringing it back down to like kindergarten science, guys, when it comes to heat, right, think of your body. When you get hot, when you're outside and you're sweating, you want to expand, you want to loosen up your shirts, right? That's what happens to the molecules inside of components most of the time, right? Except for liquids. Liquids are a little bit tricky. Now, in the cold, we want to conserve, we shrug up, we try to keep the warmth in, right? So we're tight. Okay, so enough on the kindergarten science, but ideally, again, that's how molecules work. Now, again, the exception is liquids, because when it's water and it's cold, it expands. And that's important too, especially with people dealing with cold or maybe dealing with both temperatures going back and forth. So with this in mind, we can start to understand what warping is. And warping happens in your device when the material starts to get heated up to a certain temperature, where physically it starts to change in size. And over time, if you've noticed something that's been left out in the sun for a long, long time, maybe there's a different texture to it, or maybe just a complete different curve to it for some reason, right? This does not happen overnight. But if you leave it out for one whole year, now we're probably talking about something that we need to pay attention to. Now, if you deal with cold temperatures as well, you want to keep moisture out of your enclosure. And we can do that by getting these little packets right here. They're pretty cheap. But keeping moisture out of your enclosure can prevent any kind of frost or any kind of ice to accumulate in the areas that you don't want it to accumulate. In this scenario, you can have ice build up in between components, and over time, it'll just grow and expand. Eventually, it'll snap something off. It'll break something just by the pressure of a new component, being the ice, expanding to the point where it just severs something off or breaks something or disconnects a vital connection for your miner. At the moment of this video, here are the small challenges that I see when it comes to fighting off heat. It's either a complete DIY project, or it's going to be you have to buy something and it's going to be a little bit pricey. Then on top of that, we all have different installs, so not every solution works out the best for everyone. So this is definitely a one size does not fit all situation here. Time out. Remember this. The most common and efficient ways to fight off heat is to increase airflow. As long as there's air coming in and air coming out, we have a chance. My first idea, guys, is to utilize the shade that already exists. Now, the con to this is that you might need to add some cable length. Therefore, we're going to have a little bit of loss, and then we're going to have to spend maybe $10 to $50 more on cable, just depending on what you need. But then again, you could save money by not buying all the enclosure stuff that you need if you're going to put it outside. So a little bit of pros and cons there, but utilizing shade, for example, like an attic, or maybe on doing something like this where it's just under the shade here. Now, maybe if you're doing a chimney install, something smart that you can do is put it on the side where the sun shines the least on. Now, just a quick shout out to Sarah's. I hope I'm saying that correctly, but we're in the channel here just talking a little bit about the vent system that he has running already. Now, the vent would include something like this. This is one fan that we can use. I would ideally want to use two fans and then have an intake and outtake. Now, for our setup, guys, we already use this adapter here for the power over Ethernet when we normally run it. We also have this injector here. Now, he went ahead and also validated that we have enough wattage coming through here for us to be able to add in a fan. All we need to do is just add a splitter like this from the connection that we already have, and then it would split up one going to the miner and then one going to the fan. Now, the connection that goes to the fan, we would use this connector right here as well. I'll have all these links down below if you guys want to go ahead and get started on making your own setup. But again, that brings me to my next point, that as of right now, a lot of the stuff is really just DIY. Just do it yourself. Do it how you need to do it. because it's not one size fits all, but that's what I'm gonna aim for down the road. Now, he did go on to say that he has a couple days that hit 110 degrees inside his miner, but compared to mine, I have a couple days around my 140. So that is a huge difference in temperature. Maybe if we can get that down to maybe 100 degrees, that would be really, really good. So I will have a video on me making my own little enclosure and then seeing if I can make it as simple as possible for you guys to recreate that. If it's already out, I'll put it right here. My next idea or theory that I have, and this one really is an idea, is just to make shade. Now, there are two ways I can really go about this. One is already kind of common. It's just a solar shield. If you go to RakWireless, they have it here. They're the only ones that have it that I've found so far. And this basically just goes on top of your enclosure. But this is actually designed for their enclosure, which their enclosure is well over $100. For example, their bobcat enclosure comes with a splitter and the injector that you need for PoE. But it's still $140, and that's without shipping. You guys remember that shipping is kind of ridiculous when it comes to RakWireless. They have other enclosures that are about $100. Then they have the SenseCap enclosure, which is $154. So as you can see, guys, it's just ridiculous when it starts to get, like, when you start to add pricing involved. We really are almost cornered into buying overpriced items. I tried looking and looking for a solar shield, and again, this solar shield costs $373 with a $50 shipping fee. So of course, we're not gonna order anything like this. So Dave said that he doesn't like to see me gutter rig stuff or jerry rig stuff, and I'm with you, man. I'm trying to make my stuff better. I'm trying to make it more professional. This is made specifically for the design of that enclosure. Maybe I can get one soon and see what I can add, what I can customize to this and just reuse this, because this is ideally what we need. We just need a cover. So maybe with Dave's permission, maybe we can jerry rig something like this. Well, I'm just kidding. But no, maybe we can customize something like this or just use it in a way that can benefit our enclosure, because the enclosure that we have on this channel, just the way that it's orchestrated, this may not work out. Who knows? I'm gonna try it out to see what comes out. But just to give a small perspective, I have completely different installs, so it's not like I could just bulk order all of what I need at once. I need to figure out what each one of them has. So I'll be going through that phase for you guys as well, and I will be posting everything that I come out with in the next couple of videos. For those of you who are unfamiliar, this is our enclosure that we use on this channel. Usually I have the links down below for something that fits a bobcat. If you have a I think it's called a Linux dot, those are a little wider, I believe, so you might need to go a size higher. But nevertheless, ours isn't as fancy as this one right here, because this one has like the correct adapters so it can make the cables waterproof. But I have had zero problems. It works out great. But if you really wanted to have those connectors, you can actually just scroll down and they're actually right here. You can add them to your enclosure. Now, of course, you need to figure out what cable size you need, but that should be pretty simple enough. Flagpole installs start to get a little tricky, right? We cannot start to add all this weight on top unless you have a super sturdy flagpole. We're a little bit limited as to what kind of weight we can be putting on top of the miner. Therefore, maybe making a whole solar shield and a vent is not really the best thing. Maybe what we need to do is we need to get a cable and run it all the way down to the bottom of the flagpole, so that way we can add a solar cover. So again, it's whatever just fits best for you. The downside, of course, will be the loss that we mentioned in the beginning. And then going back to rooftop mounts, if you have a pole that's on top of your roof that's super flimsy, that's not gonna be able to take the weight, then you probably have to revert back to the rules for the flagpole one. Now, my other option for a flagpole is to maybe make some kind of vents without any fans inside. These vents would just be natural vents to get some natural airflow in there. I think it would help out a lot, especially if the miner is getting up to 160 degrees. Maybe we can bring it down 30 degrees. I'm not sure. I'm just throwing out numbers here. Now, I do believe that my flagpoles will be able to take the weight of adding something on there. I just don't want to go overboard. I already have enough weight on the flagpole itself, and maybe having a little fan in there that's lightweight might be better than adding a solar shield. The reason why is because if it gets super, super windy, yes, that solar shield is actually lighter, but it catches a lot more wind high up in the air with the flagpole. So just think about elevation, guys. If you're gonna use a solar wind, you probably don't want to be super high up unless you're super sturdy, like mounted to the chimney. But if you're just kind of just in the air with a flagpole or something like that, you probably don't want to go with the solar shield since it'll catch a ton of that wind. Which brings me to my ending conclusion of what I think we can do. Now, I did reach out to two manufacturers to see if we can create some kind of enclosure, and they replied back telling me, give me some schematics or something that you want drawn. So maybe you guys want to step in here, right? Those of you who like to draw, or maybe you guys want to throw a design, we can all work collectively to make our own little enclosure of what we want. We can make it just have some natural vents. Now, I do have ideas, and if you guys are interested, I will be talking about that in the Discord. If you guys want to hop on and maybe just make some kind of enclosure, if we get the right kind of help and if we get something, we can send it over to them and maybe we can get a quote and see what we can get. Now, the reason I think about this is because all these other enclosures out there, especially that they sell for helium mining specifically, are just completely overpriced, and I don't agree with any of that. At the end of the day, guys, it's only molded plastic put together and they're selling it for $300. That's ridiculous. Now, I hope that you have enjoyed this video. I will be putting out more stuff very soon, so thank you guys for being here. Thanks for watching. Thank you for all the comments and really just getting involved with this channel. So I sincerely and humbly appreciate you guys. As always, the affiliate links are down below, and I gave you guys my gratitude for using the affiliate links. I know some of you go out of your way to click on the links, and I really just want to give you my extra thanks for that. So thank you guys. I'll see you guys next time.